Do you see this video now?
Yes.
Yes, okay. So without comment first. Now we are in the right loop. And now the left lobe is presented. So first I try to present the pole. This is not closely related to our today topics, but I think it would be a opportunity to. Here we are. Okay. So, do you see this pole? Can you see? No. So, which is the least likely histological diagnosis in the event of one of the right nodules? So, I turn back to this case. So, which is the least likely histological diagnosis? So, in this nodular mass. Not this, but this one. Which is the least likely histological diagnosis? Hyperplastic nodule, follicular tumor, or papillary cancer? So, back to this one. I give you one additional minute to answer the poll. And thereafter, I will try to present the distribution of answers. So I play again. For the poll, this is the lesion in question. Okay, I go back to the pool. 25% of the responders stated the hyperplastic nodule is the least likely. 20% stated that follicular tumor, and 16% stated that papillary cancer. If we miss or abandon the no answers, then around almost the half stated that hyperplastic nodule is the least likely diagnosis. I disagree with. So the presentation of the different tumors and different pathologies will be discussed later in the course, but such presentation is a very characteristic of a hyperplastic nodule. A follicular nodule is usually a single large lesion within a nodule. Naturally, I cannot exclude the possibility that one or more nodules within this nodular mass would be a follicular adenoma, but this presentation, these three nodules next to each other, is very characteristic of hyperplastic nodule. So once more, occasionally papillary cancer can present in this form, but the most likely diagnosis viewing this ultrasound presentation in this nodular mass is hyperplastic nodule. This has relevance when we target this nodule and gain follicular proliferation on cytology, then this follicular proliferation would not be a follicular tumor with great probability. We can gain follicular tumor-like cytological pattern from each and every thyroid lesions, including Hashimoto's thyroiditis and hyperplastic nodules, not only from follicular tumors. Comments or questions about this question and poll?
Just to be sure, Thomas, please, what do you call a hyperplastic nodule?
There are three main pathological entities in a nodule. The benign hyperplastic nodules, the follicular tumors, follicular adenoma, and the thyroid cancers. So effectively, we have not a fourth type of thyroid pathologies in the event of a thyroid nodule. Okay, this is not a cytological diagnosis, hyperplastic nodule, but I asked what is the histological, least probable histological type in this lesion. So we have three opportunities: follicular tumor, hyperplastic nodule, or thyroid cancer, and I think that the least probable possibility is follicular tumor, which very rarely presents in such form. Okay, but this was...
May I have a question?
No, please.
I'm sorry, but we do not use such terms in France as hyperplastic nodule. That's my question. So I do not know what it is.
In histopathologic colloid goiter, colloid nodule, which are not non-tumorous, what is your, the phrase for this?
I understand. In French, we say hyperplasic.
Hyperplasic.
Okay. Yeah, hyperplasic is your hypoplastic, but this to me can't be a hyperplastic nodule. There are not hypoechoic. They have no colloids. They are isoechoic, and they do not look like this.
Okay.
Sorry.
Okay.
This is disagreement between experts.
Okay. I think it is important, it's very good. So Gilles Rousse, one of the greatest experts in thyroidology, states that the final histopathology was in these two nodules in the right lobe, in this one, and in this nodular mass, hyperplastic nodule. Or how is it in French? How is it in French?
It can be benign. It can be benign, of course.
Yes. Okay.
But the precise denomination wouldn't be that one to my mind.
There was another question.
It was me. My question is, if it will be a follicular tumor, should we always see a halo or a capsule around it, or it's not necessary?
Yes.
Always.
I agree with you. Almost 90% of follicular tumors present with halo sign. Not all, but almost 90%. But this is not a decisive sign, because halo does not always reflect the capsule of a nodule. It can represent compressed vascular or other anatomical structures. So this is not a specific feature of follicular tumor, but it is a very sensitive feature of follicular tumor. So if we lack the halo sign, then it is a very strong argument against follicular tumor. Other? Well, and so this was not the topic. The topic was the borders of these lesions. So first, see this one. Not the right position, but I tried to stop the video. So the issue is whether this mass is composed of one or two nodules. If it is a single nodule, then these borders should be regarded as lobulations, but I'm not absolutely sure that this lesion, I play it with moderately high polyclonic nodule? If not, let's analyze this nodular mass. The mass as a whole clearly has irregular borders, for example, here and here. But in this case, I think it is more evident that this is composed of multiple nodules. There is no continuation between this part and this part. It is hard to imagine a section in which these are separated, absolutely separated from each other. So I think that in this case, this lobulation should not be regarded as pathological. In this case, I accept the view of Gilles that it is a single nodule, but in this larger hypochoic mass, in the event of these cystic lesions, I think that these are this is not a pathological form of lobulation because it is composed of multiple nodules next to each other. Questions, comments, disagreement? In the left lobe. So I think that considering or taking into account this and this feature and also this one, it seems to be clearly that this nodule has irregular lobulated margins, for example, here. And again, in this view, it seems to have taller than wide sign as well. So once more, this left nodule. And what does this nodule contain? So what intranodular hyperechoic figure does this nodule have? Are you here?
Macroclassification?
Maybe macroclassification also, because at some part of the nodule we can see an acoustic shadow, but not macro, but I think microclassification is the more interesting. So here is incomplete acoustic shadow. So you have right that this nodule very likely has macro classification, but also has micro classifications as well.
The capsule is infiltrated by the nodule.
Who? Please, once more.
The thyroid capsule is infiltrating by the nodule.
Yes, yes, you are right. It was the relevant section. Yes, so here is the thyroid, not real capsule. The thyroid has only pseudo capsule, but here is this one and here is this one. So this nodule presented extra thyroid extension, and this is a very suspicious pattern for an extra thyroid extension. So it was a very clever comment. Beside microcalcification, irregular borders, this nodule also presents signs of extra thyroid extension. So here is the capsule, and here is the other, and here the capsule is discontinuous. The nodule also shows abutment, which is the second sign, and not only abutment, but also bulging. Here is the ventral level of the lobe, and this bulges into the strap muscle. So all three possible signs of a possible extrathyroid extension are present in this nodule. Any other comments, questions? Okay, if not, I turn to the next case.